Alpha gamma motor neurons are involved in the final common pathway from the anterior gray matter of the spinal cord. We have muscle spindle in which the extra fusel fibers or the contractile muscle fibers having the actin myosin filaments, and the blue color fibers are the intrafusal fibers or the muscle spindle, so-called muscle spindle, or sensors of the muscle spindles, which sense the contractility length relationships. We have anterior horn from where the alpha motor neuron emerges and supplies to the extrafusal fibers or the contractile elements of the skeletal muscles through neuromuscular junction. And from the intrafusal fibers, the sensors, the afferent sensors, emerges and ends in the anterior horn cell. The collateral of the sensory fibers ends in the anterior horn cell. And these sensory fibers having the runs through the dorsal horn cell into the spinal cord and ending on the alpha motor neuron. And the majority of the fibers ascends to the cerebellum and other parts in the brainstem for the proprioception of the muscle stretch, tension, etc. And the gamma motor neuron, one of the important neuron, also emerges from the anterior horn gray matter of the spinal cord, which involves in the muscle, the contractility, stretch, the muscle tension and all. So gamma motor neuron stimulation would increases the tension in the muscle spindle. And we also have some interneurons maybe ending on the alpha motor neuron or gamma motor neuron, and we have many interneurons in the anterior horn cells, and these anterior horn cells have fed by the descending corticospinal tracts. Many corticospinal tracts already have discussed in my previous videos, and here we have vestibulospinal tract, olivospinal tract, tectospinal tract, and reticulospinal tract, and one more is reticulospinal tract fibers, ipsi and contralateral fibers, ending on the gamma motor neuron or interneuron. Especially this interneuron in turn feeds the alpha motor neuron, which is the final common pathway of the motor fibers, ending on the muscle fibers. And lastly, the corticospinal tract is a majority of the fibers, ends on the alpha motor neurons, which facilitates the motor activity. And the remaining minor descending fibers, of course, will not directly involve in the motor activity or mobility. Motor means mobility, motor activity, and modulates the motor action. And Renshaw neuron is the neuron, inhibitory neuron, emerges somewhere in between the alpha motor neuron. So the collateral of the alpha motor neuron ending on the Renshaw neuron, which inhibits in turn the alpha motor neuron for precise action potential delivery to the muscle fibers, contractile muscle fibers. This is how the alpha motor neuron directly influenced by the corticospinal tract and modulates by the other corticospinal tract and interneurons in the anterior gray horn. So kindly you may subscribe my channel for more videos.